Transmitting loading information. The information given at the foot of the aircraft in an often noisy environment can sometimes be poorly or incorrectly understood. As in this incident reported by the BEA in 1998 during a Lille-Bastia-Palermo flight.
We put the Bastia luggage in the aft hold, Palermo in the forward hold.
We put the luggage, Bastia in the forward hold and Palermo in the aft hold.
The resulting errors, in this case a non-compliance with the loading plan, can have serious consequences. The aircraft bound for Palermo makes a stopover at Bastia.
We unload the luggage, except that for Palermo, which stays on board.
The agents in Bastia follow the oral instructions. They do not detect the inversion made at the start and leave more weight than expected at the back. The aircraft is therefore outside the weight and balance limits when it takes off for Palermo. The nose of the aircraft suddenly lifts. The crew aborts the takeoff, and the aircraft comes back down heavily on the nose gear. The merely oral transmission of information and the lack of verification contributed to this incident. Three rules must be observed when receiving or transmitting loading information. Upon receiving information, make sure you understand it, for example by repeating the main items, and taking notes if needed.
We put the Bastia luggage in the aft hold, Palermo in the forward hold.
Okay, Bastia in the front, Palermo in the back.
No, it's the opposite.
At the slightest doubt, do not hesitate to ask the person to repeat or specify.
We put the Bastia luggage in the aft hold, Palermo in the forward hold.
I didn't catch that. Could you repeat?
Always give clear and unambiguous indications.
Unload the luggage from hold 4. Those in hold 1 stay on board. They continue to Palermo.
Make sure the information has been understood by having it repeated.
Understood.
Understood. We unload hold 4.
Lay the ground for a safe flight.